Ladies and gentlemen, tonight, fighting out of the blue corner this evening, he stands 5'9" tall. He weighs in at 148 pounds. Fighting out of St. Louis, Missouri, David Grant. His opponent tonight, fighting from across the cage out of the red corner this evening. He stands 6 feet tall, weighs in at 146 pounds. He's fighting out of St. Louis, Missouri, Greg Freund.
Referee Mark Wassum has the call for this contest. Boy, Greg Freund looks immediately here ready to go. He has got all eyes on David Grant. Here we go, no touch of the gloves. Immediately Freund comes out with a big kick. Nice blitz there though coming from Grant. Big takedown there from Freund.
Great trip.
Grant doing a good job here of maintaining that closed guard position. Freund trying to do some straighten to shake him off here as Grant moves his way to high guard.
Not really able to get any offense here going for Freund yet. That high guard kind of keeps you down a little bit lower, but also they both seem just a little bit scrambly as the fight started on.
Yeah, there was a big blitz there that came out of Grant, which got us into this position. Grant has a good job here, though, of capturing that arm of Freund.
Freund needs to swim this over and pass this guard. He's got his head high.
Trying to make his way there around Grant, trying to look for that side control. Grant doing a good job here, though, of maintaining position, trying to stand up. And it works. But he eats some knees in the process.
Good knees by Freund. Good head position, too.
Oh, big one right there.
That one might have hit the cup.
Little low there coming from Freund. Now, Grant will get 5 minutes here to recover. Definitely never a good feeling there coming to take that low blow. But we definitely saw that knee right to the cup.
And those happen in the clinch long thing. It's unfortunate. If you have a really good cup, sometimes you can prevent that little sick feeling in your gut. Sometimes it just hits spot on. But this will slow the fight down. They came out scrambling. They were really ready to get after each other.
They were definitely pushing the pace immediately. Grant says he is ready to go.
One positive he gets out of that is that he's getting out of a bad position.
Definitely. Immediately back into it. Oh, Freund needs some shots coming in. But again, knees to the body. Freund trying to sit down for that double leg. Nice turnout, though, by Grant.
Grant's really holding on to the cage here.
Freund trying to make his way over as we are down to 1 minute remaining here in round one.
Don't let him get your back. Hey, turn into him. Come on now.
Very tough position here for Grant.
Absolutely. If he can find a way to land some shots while his head's not very braced, he might be able to really deal some damage here.
Oh, Freund looking for that rear naked choke.
Unfortunately, he's falling off the side.
30 seconds remaining here in round one. Now Grant trying to do some damage. Referee Mark Wassum has warned him on multiple times about touching the cage.
Very interesting stoppage there like that.
Back into position. Grant doing a good job here of being heavy. Oh, sinks in that potential. Looking for another knee to the body there.
Freund gets up without even having an underhook. He just stood up. There goes the mouthpiece.
It is the end of round one. Very tough round. Now, Grant has been warned here multiple times on the cage grab. That is huge in this. If he gets a point taken, how do you see that first round?
I see it as Freund's. Freund had a good chance to finish that fight with a good submission attempt. It just didn't stay under and he fell off. He had a good position to land some hard shots too. The thing about an opponent grabbing the fence multiple times like that is that when you're really bracing for that takedown and you're pulling on it, and then they grab the fence and you have to do it over and over again, that really adds up. It's not very fun to do because you just have to keep redoing it.
So if you're in the corner of David Grant, what are you telling him now after that scramble, after taking the shot to the cup, what is the next step as we get into round two?
Well, the moments of success he had was with the blitzes. But when he gets to the cage, he doesn't need to grab him. I would say blitz him to the cage and then stay in front of him and find your range and work from there. Because whenever you're grabbing a hold of him, it's just ending up in a dogfight thing. You weren't really winning at those aspects.
Here we go, round two. Freund immediately comes out with the kicks. Grant fights with his chin very high. Trying to stalk down Freund here, putting him in the corner.
He's almost leading with his head.
Trying to scramble out of that single leg position. Freund pushing him up against the cage, trying to use it, working to clasp those hands. Working that high crotch position. Grant doing a good job, though, to stave the takedown. Again, Freund trying to keep the heaviness here in the corner.
He's a maintained head position, and when his legs come together, then he can really reach around those knees and get him down. If that's what he's wanting to do, or is he just trying to grind him out here?
Separate him back into the center of the cage goes Grant. Freund is not liking those shots, though. It's backing him up and making him go for that shot every time. Grant trying to slide that position, works his way into half guard. Ground and pound here coming from Grant. Freund trying to minimize that damage. Grant trying to work in here to get some position, trying to make a little space to land those hands. As we're down here to 1 minute remaining here in round two. This is not the position that Freund wants to be in with his head on the canvas like this.
Not at all. He needs to kick away and try and get out.
Oh, rolling for knee bar. Under 1 minute remaining here. Freund trying to get up, but Grant does a great job here of maintaining that knee on belly position, now working to get some shots in.
Freund had his chance to stand up. It looks like he just wants to work from bottom.
Oh, looking for the arm bar. Under 30 seconds. Can Grant do it? Nice block there, though, coming from Freund. Oh, bad position. Grant trying to set him up. 10 seconds remaining. Decides to abandon it and just land some punches. Nice ground and pound to finish the round there from Grant.
Yeah, when he knew he wasn't going to be able to grab that arm bar, instead of just pulling on it, he decided to land whatever shots he could.
So how do you see this fight as we get ready to go into round three?
In my opinion, it's at 1-1. Freund in that round seemed happier to work off of his back than to stand up and trade. I'm not sure why that would be. Maybe he was a little tired. Maybe he saw something he wanted to work from there. And Grant was able to be on top and land a little bit more offense. Interesting. I have it 1-1. It could be a totally different tale in the third round. Who knows?
So if you are in the corner of Greg Friend, what kind of advice are you giving as we see UFC veteran Luigi Fioravanti in his corner?
I would tell him to take the center and then push him back more toward the cage. Grant is blitzing him, and in those moments, they're committing the shots, and one of them is ducking and looking to take it to the ground at that point. They need to pin him against the cage and use the work in that way instead of giving up those blitzes. There's more room to back up and move from those blitzes.
Third and final round coming up. Oh, immediately Freund leads with a kick. Again, Freund shoots in here trying to get that single leg. Working the double.
Got both hands closed right under it. Was able to just pull it right out.
This is a good position here for Freund in this round, if it is indeed 1-1 going into the third and final.
Absolutely. He can really just slow it down here and grind on him. There's no reason to be in too big of a hurry. You got to work, though, because the ref might stand you up otherwise. From here, he could dig this head in right there, just like that, and he can really put the pressure on his jaw and land multiple strikes. He's getting plenty of direction from his corner about what to do here to stay active, too.
As we said, we hear UFC vet Luigi Fioravanti telling him, body, body, head, trying to make some space. You have to land shots if you're in this position, or the ref will stand you up.
Definitely. They've been shown to do that even in half guard.
Freund is trying to keep that pressure on. Grant has to do something here as we are approaching halfway through the third and final round in this contest.
Freund is doing a great job of here, slowing it down, staying just active enough. He's going to see what's given to him here because he's ahead. He doesn't need to rush anything. If a guard pass is given to him, I'm sure he'll take it. But he's looking to just keep the weight on him and beat on him. He's doing a good job of that right now.
A lot of heavy, heavy pressure here coming out of Greg Freund.
And Grant's head is just inverted on the cage. You really have no leverage when that happens. If someone takes your head and your spine away from you, there's just not very much strength you can muster from that position.
It's also incredibly uncomfortable to have your head being ground into the cage like that.
And if someone hits you in that position, there is no cushion.
Freund working his way into side control. Grant trying to get that knee in there to make some space to get back into some sort of half guard.
Freund gets them out, hooks the legs.
30 seconds remaining here in the third and final round of this contest.
He's in good position here to close this one out. He can land a little bit of offense. I really doubt a ref will stand you up and mount. I've not seen it.
Grant trying to make a last-ditch effort here to try to get out of this position, fighting the hands here of Freund. Nice turn there coming from Grant. Not a position Freund wanted to be in with 10 seconds remaining in the contest.
But he stood right back up and didn't sit down there and take any damage to close out the fight.
What a fight, ladies and gentlemen.
Ladies and gentlemen, your winner by unanimous decision out of the red corner, Greg Freund.
Greg Freund